this illustrates a story I first told in this context, 2016, an event down in London. And the principles and values in the story became quite important to us as an organisation at Neighbourhood Watch Scotland in kind of finding our direction at this time. So I'll start with telling the story. That's actually meant to me as a child and as an adult. And I was brought up on a council housing estate in Kilmarnock, Ayrshire, mid-60s. And one of my most vivid memories has been in our back garden with my mum while she was hanging out the washing. And we lived in a street, there was 18 houses either side. We were about 8 down from the top of the street. And while my mum was hanging the washing out, she was talking to all the neighbours, and there was Sheena and Ruby, Fiona, Mrs. McCubbin, the Toners, the Stewarts, remember them all, Parkers and the Roonies across the road. And whilst there was a lot of gossip going on, no doubt, there was also a lot of exchange about things that were happening, and people were supporting each other. And it really came to light for me. There was, my dad was a fireman, and he was off duty, and there was a serious fire in the street down the other side of the road. Thankfully, nobody was injured, but the household was gutted with smoke damage, and they lost everything, because in the 60s, you didn't really have that great insurance on contents and things. But what I remember was, it wasn't the public services, it wasn't the local authority, or fire and rescue, or some charity, or whatever, that came to the support of that family. It was us, it was the neighbours. And everybody gave them something. I think I lost out it slightly because I had to share a single bed with my brother for a wee while. So we gave a single bed away. But for me, whilst that might feel a bit idyllic and, oh, that's great, that community works like that, for me that was just total normality. That's what happened. And we didn't really see public services that often. I just saw the minister or the priest more often than we saw public services in our street. Now I left early 80s to join the police up in Glasgow, and I remember going back probably mid 80s, and it was like a different street. There was 6 foot panel fences between gardens. My mum no longer knew everybody that was in the street, so some new people had come. Huge change in a very short time frame. And there's a lot of factors to that. There's no doubt family life changed, work life changed, there was a change in terms of home ownership, people being more transient in housing. But something changed, there's no doubt about that. And as I said, as we kind of went on as an organisation, some of those themes and discussions that came out of that story became quite important to us. The one thing we inherited as an organisation, we spent probably 70% of our time being us and 30% being why we were there in the first place, actually engaging. And we didn't have a big fancy business plan at that time. It was simply, we need to change that. We need to flip it over and spend so much more time and resource in engaging and less time being ourselves. And we did that. And there's two of us, plus Barry's in the office, running the office, and the two of us, myself and Willie Clark, probably attend between 80 and 100 community meetings a year. And that's not partner meetings, that's community meetings in our community. And we've learned an awful lot from those. And there's no doubt about it, whilst this depicts the police, this is the general public services, that's what the public were used to. Familiarity, that physical engagement, accessibility, that has changed. No matter how you want to paint it, that has changed. So out of that engagement process, whilst there was that recognition that support mechanisms for public services and things had changed, I think we also found there was a realisation within communities that, yeah, it has changed. We need to actually do a bit more for ourselves and take a bit more responsibility and ownership, but we still need support and guidance and facilitation. That led to the first of our kind of two key principles emerging, which is your watch, your way. And we had this model, which was basically take this wee toolkit and you fit it into your community, and that's you get neighbourhood watch. It doesn't work that way, because it doesn't fit, one size doesn't fit all, and communities are very we were finding through our engagement, whilst the catalyst for them coming together might have been crime, it might have been flooding, it might have been something else, once you engaged at that level, there was a myriad of things came out. And certainly we found that Neighbourhood Watch from the inside looked very different than it did from the outside. Because I think from the outside, Neighbourhood Watch is generally perceived to be a bit crime. It's perceived to be maybe about exclusion. You build a boundary around your area to keep folk out, keep crime out. And we were finding something different. And that whole process has really helped us to engage and for the whole network to grow. And where that's taken us, at the moment we've got 20,600 registered users. As far north as Orkney, down to Lockerbie, to Dunbar in the east, over to Oban and Greenock and places, so all over Scotland. And within that, they can be linked to groups, some of them are not, but we have 1,820 registered community groups. And probably an initial direct engagement to about 250,000 plus homes. And it's growing all the time. What we found through that process, it was usually there was a catalyst, yes, at a community level, but you could get people together. But the thing that was missing was for people to take, to be empowered, to take an interest in the community, to do things for themselves, they still needed information. And that should have been easy because we're living in an information age. There's information firing at you all over the place, but we were finding it wasn't this. People wanted locally relevant, timeous, accurate, trusted information. They wanted to get the right information to the right people at the right time, and that doesn't work the way we were doing it because we spent so much time doing social media, and we pulled back from that considerably. And done more of a direct engagement to assist us do this because we can't go to every meeting we're asked to go to. We have a neighbourhood alert messaging system. It's our database, but it's also a communication mechanism. And it's a very good one because it's very targeted. So people register with us, they put in their own demographic profile, they tell us what they're interested in, they tell us how they want to receive information. And we then rely on a local administrator network to get that information out. Whilst we can put stuff out centrally, and we do that as well through our partners, SCSN, government, and police and things, people want that local context. And at the moment we've got about 80 to 100 local administrators, and they can be police officers, but some of them are local authority. Staff, some of them are people from SECA we work with, people from certain utilities who have networks, so various people input into the system. But that is the two key principles we now work on. You watch your weight, it has to fit that community, and to make it fit or to understand how it fits, you need to engage. And then the second one is, once they've formed that in a nucleus in the community, you need to get the right information. Because if you do, they can make decisions for themselves, they can take ownership. And that whole process seems to be going down really well. Like just some comments we get back. And people like that local information, they like that engagement. And what we're finding, the partners who are now heavily engaged with it, particularly Police Scotland, are getting a lot of value from it. So it works. Your challenge in terms of this, I know that was very quick, but I was trying to get some time back for Hannah, and I'm happy to speak to Andy throughout the course of the morning. If you want community participation and empowerment and ownership, how are you going to get the right information to the right people at the right time? Because we have found that doesn't work through websites or social.